In last class, we have discussed about what is endocrine system, how it is different from the nervous system, as well as how it is related to the nervous system. So we have discussed the similarity with the nervous system. We have discussed its differences from the nervous system. Then we have discussed about different endocrine cells, the different kind of cells which secretes the hormone, okay, like endocrine cells, then exocrine cells, then paracrine cells. Then we have seen how the hormones travels from one gland to the another, or from one side to the another in the organism body through blood. Then how different type of receptors take the hormones, and then it goes inside the cell, and how these chemical messengers triggers the secondary and tertiary response. Okay, we have gone through all those things. Now today we will take the endocrine glands and the hormones in fishes particular. Okay, so as I have told, when we talk about the endocrine glands, we are talking about the ductless glands that release the secondary product, that release the chemical messenger directly into the blood or the lymph, okay, which perform or regulate several physiological process inside the cell, okay, inside the cell or inside the organism. Okay, these processes may include sexual activity, the reproduction behavior, growth, osmoregulation, general metabolic activities to support the life. Okay, it includes like storage of food, utilization of food, blood pressure, even the pigmentation in the color, the pigmentation or the skin color. It's all these metabolic processes are regulated through the enzymes or through the hormones which is secreted by the endocrine glands. Okay, so today we will take the major endocrine glands of the fishes one by one. The number one is the master gland, the pituitary gland or hypophysis, then thyroid gland. Actually, these two glands, the pituitary gland and thyroid gland, these two glands are the chief glands of the fishes. Okay, so means the hormones which is secreted by these two glands, they play a major role in the regulation of the metabolic process inside the organism body. Okay, then there are some other glands like interrenal bodies or chromaffin cells, then corpuscle of Stanius, ultimobranchial glands, urohypophysis, pancreatic islets, juxtaglomerular cells, and pineal glands. Okay, so today we will take these glands one by one. So first we will start the location. Okay, we'll see what are the physical location, a generalized typical location of these endocrine glands in fishes or in teleost. Okay, so we'll start from the master gland, pituitary. So pituitary and pineal gland, these two glands are situated in the cerebrum cavity or in the near the brain. Then the chromaffin tissue, it is located in the upper kidney region. Now they are classed on the basis of their organization and function. Okay, these endocrine glands are divided into three major categories. The one category is the chief endocrine gland. So basically pituitary and thyroid, they are the two main glands. Okay, as pituitary, we all know, it's also known as a master gland, because the secretion from the pituitary, it controls the secretion of the other hormones from other a different endocrine glands which is situated distantly in the organism body, as well as the thyroid gland, which have the influence on several metabolic process which is running inside the cell, okay, or the organism body. Then the second one is there are some organ in the fishes particularly, they perform both the endocrine and the exocrine function. The endocrine function means they creates the chemical messenger or the hormone in the directly into the blood or the lymph, and then the exocrine, this secretes the chemical messenger through the duct, okay, or in some confinement. So there are basically three organs which have both. endocrine and exocrine function, that is kidney, gonads, and intestine. Okay, then there are some scattered cells with endocrine function. Means if we talk about the glands, glands is basically an organized structure, an organ from where the hormones get secreted. But in fishes, there are some scattered cells. Scattered means distributed, big way. Okay. Some scattered cell which have the endocrine function means they synthesize and secretes the hormones, okay, but they are not organized as an organ, okay, or as a gland, okay. So the typical example of this is scattered endocrine cells are basically the paracrine cells which is present in the digestive tract of the fishes, which helps in the digestion and absorption of the food in fishes. Okay, now the classification of chemical nature of the hormone. Okay, so basically hormone is a chemical messenger. Okay, it regulates several processes, but chemically they are divided into three major category. The first one is the steroid. So two hormones, the testosterone male specific hormone and the estradiol female specific hormones, these two are the steroids which is secreted by the gonads of the male and female. Then majority of the hormones are protein or peptides. Okay, they are secreted by the pituitary, thyroid and the interrenal tissues. And the third category is the amino acid analogs. Okay, means they are basically the amino acids. So epinephrine, norepinephrine, which are collectively means epinephrine and norepinephrine together known as the catecholamines, they are basically the amino acid analogs. So these are three major category in which the hormones are divided based on their chemical nature: the steroids, proteins, and amino acid analogs. Now, first we will take the master gland, pituitary gland, or hypophysis. Okay, so location, if I'm talking a typical location of the pituitary gland in the fishes, is basically it is under the diencephalon region of the brain. If you remember in the last course anatomy, okay, so in that course we have discussed the nervous system of the fishes, is it? You remember?
Yes.
So in the nervous system of the fishes, what we have seen, the brain have three regions: forebrain, midbrain, and hindbrain. Remember? Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
The forebrain have two regions. The one is telencephalon and another one is diencephalon. Okay. So pituitary is basically situated underside the diencephalon region of the brain. Okay. Is it clear? This is a very important, you have to remember this because in many competitive exams, okay, this question come as a, in multiple choice question, the exact location of the pituitary, okay. So this is basically located underside the region of the cephalon, okay, or below the optic chiasma of the brain, okay. So if we talk about the structure of the pituitary, it has two regions, okay. One is adenohypophysis and another one is the neurohypophysis. Okay, so the adenohypophysis is also known as the anterior pituitary and the neurohypophysis is known as the posterior pituitary region. Okay, so anterior pituitary or the adenohypophysis, it is developed from the ectoderm of the buccal cavity, okay, which is called the Rankine pound, and the neurohypophysis or the posterior region of the pituitary, it develops from the floor of the embryonic diencephalon, means the diencephalonic region of the embryo. Okay, so the adenohypophysis, anterior pituitary, neurohypophysis, posterior pituitary. Adenohypophysis developed from the dorsal invagination of the ectodermal part of the buccal cavity, and neurohypophysis developed from the floor of the embryonic diencephalon. Okay, so your pituitary, it is attached to the brain through a stalk. It's called infundibular stalk or neurohypophysal stalk. Okay. So now these are the different part of the pituitary, the name of the divisions, and then what kind of secretions they, or what type of hormones they secretes and what are the function. This is basically a comprehensive slide, okay, which shows which depicts about the structure, division, and function of the pituitary gland. So I, as I have told, there is a two parts of the pituitary: the adenohypophysis, which is also known as the anterior pituitary, and the neurohypophysis, which is known as the posterior pituitary. So this anterior pituitary or the adenohypophysis have three regions. Okay, the proximal pars distalis, the rostral pars distalis, and pars intermedia. Okay, proximal pars distalis is on proximal side, this is on rostral side, and this is intermediate. Okay, and these are the type of cells which is present in these three divisions, and these are the secretion. So the proximal pars distalis, this secretes thyroid stimulating hormone. It's then this it also secretes the gonadotropic releasing hormone GTH. FSH and LH. Okay, but in fishes the terminology is GTH1 and GTH2. Gonadotropic hormone 1 and gonadotropic hormone 2. Then the somatotropic hormone or the growth hormone, and then your pars distalis secretes the prolactin and corticotropin, which is also known as corticotropin or adenocorticotropic hormone. Now this is pars intermedia, where the melanocyte stimulating hormone and melanophore contracting hormones. Okay, these are the hormones which regulates the pigment photoreceptors, because they are basically secretory and their photoreceptor in function, they actually have role or regulation of the pigmentation in the fishes. Okay, now there is a two or the three hormones actually which is secreted from the neurohypophysis or the pars nervosa, that is the vasopressin and oxytocin. It regulates the osmoregulation, salt water balance, and it also have some role in the mating and the egg laying or the reproduction. Okay, so we will see all these hormones one by one. Okay, so first, actually the secretions, if I'm talking about the secretion from the pituitary glands, okay, the hormones which is secreted through the pituitary glands, they have tropic and non-tropic effects. Means there is a two type of hormones, two category of the hormones. One category of the hormones which have the tropic effects, and there is another category of the hormones which have a non-tropic effect, and the third category which have both the tropic as well as the non-tropic effects. If I'm talking about the tropic effect, means I'm talking about the hormones that the hormones which is secreted from the pituitary triggers the secretion of another hormone from another, the secretion of another group of or set of hormones from endocrine gland, which is situated distantly from the pituitary, and this that resulted into the, and that the hormones, when the pituitary triggers the secretion of the hormone from other endocrine gland, then they secrete some set of hormones, and those set of hormones act on the target organ. So that is known as a tropic effect. Means that the secretion from the pituitary doesn't directly reach to the target organ. Okay, a secretion from the pituitary, it goes to the another endocrine gland, and that endocrine secretes some set of hormones, and that set of hormones actually is known as a group of hormones which have a tropic effect. Now they secrete some of the non-tropic hormones which directly act on the target organ, and there are one hormone which is known as a growth hormone, or in fishes they are known as a somatotropic hormones. They have both tropic and non-tropic effect. Means they act directly on target organ, as well as they trigger hormones that triggers the secretion of some other set of hormone from other endocrine glands. Okay, so here are this FSH or LH, or we can say that the GTH1 and GTH2. So GTH1 and GTH2, these are the hormones which are secreted by the pituitary. Now these hormones, they actually triggers the secretion of the sex hormone or the sex steroid from testes and ovaries of the or the gonads of the male or the female fish. And the TSH is another tropic hormone or the thyroid stimulating hormone, which activates or which triggers the secretion of the thyroid hormones from thyroid gland, which acts on several other target organs. Then there's a third, the fourth tropic hormone, that is the adrenocorticotropic hormone, which is actually triggers the secretion of the set of hormones from the intestinal glands or the glands which is situated in the kidney. Okay, so these four are the tropic hormones, GTH1, GTH2, then TSH, ACTH. Okay, now the prolactin, MSH, or we can say that melanocyte stimulating hormone, and endorphin. These three are the non-tropic hormones, means they act directly on the target organ. They secreted from the pituitary and act on the target organ. So prolactin, it acts effect on several organs. Then MSH or the melanocyte stimulating hormone, it actually regulates the pigmentation of the skin and some organs. And then endorphins, which basically directly act on the pain receptor, which is present in the brain. And the third, the last category, which have both the effect, the non-tropic and the tropic effect, is the somatotropic hormones or the growth hormones, which have both effects. Okay. So, is it clear to everyone what is tropic and non-tropic hormones secreted from the pituitary?
Yes, ma'am.
Everyone?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Non-tropic effects, tropic hormones that is secreted from the pituitary gland. So, ma'am, the non-tropic hormones, the pituitary is secreted.
Yes, ma'am. In this side, the hormones are secreted from the pituitary.
Okay.
These all are hormones which are secreted from the pituitary only. Okay. So now we'll take the hormones which is secreted from the pituitary one by one. So first we will take the prolactin, which is secreted by the rostral peristalsis of the pituitary gland, and it actually functions predominantly in the freshwater osmotic regulation. So there the involvement is in, if you remember the very first online lecture, osmoregulation. In the osmoregulation, on the very last slide, we have discussed what are the factors which regulates the osmoregulation, which are regulate the process of osmoregulation in the fishes. And the very first one was the prolactin. Okay, so actually the prolactin have the function in the osmoregulation. It actually play a major role in the retention of the certain ion by the epithelia of the gills, kidney, urinary bladder, and it decreases the permeability of the external surface to the water. Okay, so it has a major role in osmoregulation. It also increases the GFR in the kidney. Okay, it increases the ATPase activity in the kidney and urinary bladder, and decreases the ATPase activity in the gills. These ATPase are basically the channels, ion channels, okay, which regulates the movement of chloride, sodium and potassium ions. Okay, so means the movement of the ion, okay, for maintaining the osmotic concentration of the body is also regulated by the prolactin. Okay, so basically prolactin regulates the activity of the ATPase, okay, in the gill, kidney and urinary surface. And these ATPase are basically the ion channel, which is basically the sodium, potassium and chloride ion channels. Okay, now the another hormone, the somatotropin hormone, which is also known as the growth hormones, is secreted from the peristalsis of the pituitary, and it is basically stimulate the appetite and growth, and it prevents the liver hypertrophy. Anyone can tell me what is hypertrophy? Hyper means what?
More.
Okay,
or prevent inflammation, trophy means inflammation.
Inflammation, is it? Your growth.
Yes. Wo phool na, matlab ek tarah se liver ka hyper.
Abnormal, matlab so it prevents abnormal or the overgrowth of the. Okay, so the somatotrophin, it stimulates the appetite and growth and prevents the liver hypertrophy or liver overgrowth. Okay, now the third one is the melanocyte stimulating hormone or MSH. It is secreted from the peristalsis. Okay, and this is a nootropic hormone because it directly acts on the skin. Okay, or melanocytes. Okay, so this is a nootropic one. So what it did, it actually directly act on the dispersal of the melanocyte. Okay, thereby it responsible for the darkening of the fish coloration or the pigmentation. Okay, but this is not the only hormone which is which influence the pigmentation in the fish. There is another hormone which is known as melatonin, and that melatonin is secreted from the pineal gland. Okay, or the pineal organ. So this MSH or the melanocyte stimulating hormones, it regulates the pigmentation or the coloration in the fishes, but the coloration of the fishes is also regulated by the another hormone which is secreted from the pineal body, and that hormone is melatonin. And then there are the fishes shows the camouflage also. Even some shellfishes and the teleost fishes, they show the camouflage. If you remember the last semester class of anatomy of shellfish, we were talking about the squids and cuttlefish. Na? They have ability to camouflage. Na? Yes. So when when a fish have an adaptation to change the color, okay, in very less time, then it is dependent on the nervous mechanism or the neural mechanism. Okay, and if the change of the color requires longer time, then it is under the hormonal control. Means a camouflage, if the sudden change in the color of the fish, okay, then it is controlled by the nervous system of the animal. But if it takes longer time, okay, then it is basically controlled by the hormone. So this if a longer time is required to change the color in the fish or for the camouflage, then it is by melanocyte. Okay, but if it is a very quick, then it is basically due to the neural mechanism. Now this is another tropic hormone. It is the adrenocorticotropic hormone. It is secreted by the pars distalis, okay, and it stimulates the production of cortisoids and corticosteroids from the interrenal glands in the chromaffin cell. Basically, this is very similar to the hormone which triggers the secretion of the hormone from the adrenal cortex of higher vertebrates. Okay, but here the fishes, they doesn't have the adrenal cortex, but they have some interrenal glands in the chromaffin cell which have the same which have the similar function. Okay, so these ACTH, it triggers or stimulate the production of the corticosteroids hormone by this glands, which is situated in the anterior region of the kidney. Now another one is the trypsin or TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone, which is secreted by the pars distalis, and it stimulates the secretion of the hormones from the thyroid glands. Now, the gonadotropic hormones, okay? So the fishes have two gonadotropic hormones, the GTH1 and GTH2, okay? And they are secreted by the pars distalis of the pituitary. So the release of GTH1 and GTH2 from the pituitary is under the influence of the hormone which is secreted from the hypothalamus. Okay, and that hormone is known as GnRH, gonadotropin releasing hormones. Means hypothalamus secretes the gonadotropic releasing hormone, and this hormone gives the message to the pituitary for the release of GTH1 and GTH2, or what we can say the FSH and LH. Okay, so these hormones stimulates the gonads to release the male and the female hormone. Here is the answer of Rahul. The fish is drawn and is okay.
Yes,
ma'am. These hormones the testes in the male, they release the testosterone, and the female, they release the progesterone and the estrogen sex hormone for egg and sperm production. Okay, and now the next line is the answer of the Srikanth question. The GTH1 stimulates the vitellogenesis and the GTH2 stimulates the oocyte maturation, egg release and spawning. Okay. So now the hormones which are secreted from the neurohypophysis or the posterior pituitary. Okay, so there are basically three hormones which are arginine, vasopressin, oxytocin and isotocin. Okay, isotocin is the hormone which is actually responsible for live birth in the fishes. Okay, means there are few fishes which are live bearer. Okay, they used to give birth to the young ones. Okay, they won't release egg. They used to give the birth to the young one. So in that fishes, this isotocin is help in the contraction of the ovarian muscle. Okay, so the very first hormone, the arginine vasopressin, it helps in the osmoregulation and the contraction of the smooth muscle. Oxytocin also have the role in the osmoregulation and contraction of the smooth muscle. And isotocin have the help in the ovary and ovarian muscle contraction. So these are the hormones which are the nootropic hormones secreted by the neurohypophysis. Okay. So the neurohypophysis hormone, just adjacent to the neurohypophysis, I have written the hypothalamus. Okay, actually the neurohypophysis or the posterior region of the pituitary, it secretes the hormones which is collected from the hypothalamus. Okay, means hypothalamus secretes some hormone, they get collected inside the neurohypophysis, and from neurohypophysis it gets secreted into the blood. Okay, and as I have told, there is basically three hormones which is secreted by the neurohypophysis. Number one is the oxytocin, which influences the osmoregulation. Okay, then another one is the arginine vasopressin or AVT. It helps in contraction of the anterior smooth muscle to maintain and increase the blood pressure. Okay, it also influences the osmoregulation and it increases the GFR also. Okay, now in other animals or vertebrates, this AVT actually responsible for the ovarian and oviduct muscle contraction, but in fishes, live bearing fishes, this function is replaced by the other hormone which is known as isotocin. So it's clear to everyone the hormones which is secreted from different parts of the pituitary, their function. Clear?
Ma'am, yes, one question, ma'am.
Yeah.
One question, Prashant.
हाँ.
बोले कि मैम ब्रीडिंग के टाइम पे कौन सा हार्मोन का यूज करते हैं?
क्या बोल रहे हैं?
ब्रीडिंग के टाइम पे कौन सा हार्मोन का यूज करते हैं?
GnRH.
और GnRH मेल फीमेल दोनों के लिए?
हाँ. Okay. क्योंकि GnRH ही तो पिट्यूटरी को इंड्यूस करेगा GTH1 और 2 रिलीज करने के लिए. नाउ द थायराइड ग्लैंड. ओके, सो द थायराइड ग्लैंड इन फिशेस अराइज फ्रॉम द फ्लोर ऑफ द फेरिंग्स. ओके, एक्चुअली द लोकेशन ऑफ द थायराइड ग्लैंड is not fixed in fishes. Okay, in different fishes their location is their location as well as the shape of the thyroid gland is different in fishes. Okay, there is a lot of variation in their location as well as the shape. If I'm talking about the location in the cyclostomes, okay, they are dispersed around the ventral aorta. Okay, in bony fishes they are lie under the first branchial ear. Okay, in many teleost fishes, okay, they are found along the afferent branchial arteries of the gills. In few teleost, they are migrated to the very unusual locations, like in some fishes they are near the liver, some fishes they are near the kidney, in some they are near in brain, eye, gut, spleen, gonad. Okay, so as in the platypus, it is in the gonad. Okay, so these are, so their location is different in different group of species as well as the shape. Okay, in the cyclostome, it is in the form of follicle. In manitillused, this extra diffuse is small mass of the follicle in elasma branches and bony fissure. It is a compact structure and dipnoids. Okay, this is basically have bilobed structure which is connected, okay, through a duct. So this is what the location and the shape of the thyroid glands in different group of fishes. Okay, now the secretion. Okay, so this is actually secretes three hormones, monoiodotyrosine, diiodotyrosine, and thyroxine. Thyroxine, T3 and T4. So these are the four major hormones which is secreted through the thyroid glands. Now the function of the thyroid hormones. As I have told, the pituitary and the thyroid gland, these are the two chief glands of the chief endocrine glands of the fishes. And they, you have seen the pituitary affects the almost all the physiological function of the fish, okay, or the organism. Here you see the thyroid hormones also perform various and the important physiological or the metabolic function. The very first role of the thyroid hormone is it has a role in the oxygen consumption. It influences the growth and the nitrogen metabolism or the nitrogenous waste metabolism. It involves in the carbohydrate metabolism. It influences osmoregulation. It affects the maturation, reproduction, as well as the migration. Even the brown and the rainbow trout, okay, which are basically a migratory fishes, so their adaptation to seawater, from freshwater to seawater, is required the T3 hormone. And these fishes also influence the scale. This hormone also influences the scale and bone formation in the fishes. So just see, the thyroid hormones have this many function. Okay, now another gland, the interrenal bodies or the chromaffin cell, basically the adrenal system or excretory system in the fishes are different from the mammals. Okay, basically there are two components, the interrenal bodies and the chromaffin cell. Okay, and they are basically present or the embedded in the tissue of the head kidney. If you remember the structure of the kidney, in the teleost, kidney is divided into two regions, the head region and the trunk region. So the location of the interrenal body and the chromaffin cell is in the head region of the kidney, and this secretes the corticosteroids, cortisol, cortisone, corticosterone from the interrenal cell under the influence of the pituitary hormone, the pituitary tropic hormone, that is ACTH. They also secretes the catecholamines, which is the epinephrine and norepinephrine from the chromaffin cell. So this epinephrine or the norepinephrine are basically the hormones which is secreted under the stress. So they are also known as the stress hormones or the hormones which is secreted during the fight or flight response. Okay. Now the function. They promote the utilization of the steroid fat. They are involved in the carbohydrate metabolism. They involve in the water metabolism or osmoregulation, we can say. Protein catabolism, sodium retention, electrolyte metabolism. Okay. Now another endocrine gland in the fish, that is the corpuscle of Stanius. Okay. This is attached or embedded in the kidney of the holosteum and the teleost. So it is basically outgrowth of the pro or the mesonephric duct of the kidney. The nature of the hormone which is secreted through it is a proteinaceous, and the hormone is hypocalcemic. It regulates the calcium balance in the body fluid. Then the ultimobranchial gland, it is a gland which is situated near the branchial, means gill. Okay. So this is also known as the postbranchial body or the suprapericardial body or the ultimobranchial body. Okay. They are basically, this is present between the ventral wall of the esophagus and sinus venosus. They are actually developed from the gill pouch. That's why they have the name ultimobranchial glands. Okay. It's because the last or the ultimate gill pouch. They secrete the hormone calcitonin, which regulates the calcium level in the blood. Now, the urohypophysis, which is also known as the caudal neurosecretory organ, which its position is in the caudal peduncle of the fish, okay? So, or the tail, we can say that. It secretes the hormone urotensin 1, 2, 3, and 4. And this urotensin have several functions. The main function is the increase in the salt retention in kidney and gill. And it also increase the GFR, glomerular filtration rate. Now, the pancreatic islets. Okay, the fishes does not have a clear pancreas. Okay, it is a hepato. Fishes have the hepatopancreas, means the liver has some scattered pancreatic glands or cells, okay, that secretes the pancreatic juice and the pancreatic hormones. So basically, the hormones, insulin is secreted by the hepatopancreas or the pancreatic islets. And fishes are actually semi-diabetic. Semi-diabetic because the sugar or the blood glucose regulation is very poor in fishes. So whenever if you have to take the blood glucose, if you have to check the blood glucose level of the fishes, it is bit higher side. It is on bit higher side. That is why they are considered as semi-diabetic. Okay. So this is the major hormone which is secreted from this. This is the insulin. Now the pineal gland. Pineal gland is another gland which is arise from the posterior mid-dorsal invagination of the epithalamus. Epithalamus is basically a region of the brain, okay? And it secretes the melatonin, which have the photosensory function or which have the role in pigmentation in the fishes as well as the receptor, the photoreceptor, and have some role in the photo reception or the light reception in
ma'am.
Yes
ma'am, fishes ko bhi diabetes hota hai kya?
Fishes hamesha diabetic rehti hain.
Acha, diabetic rehti hai.
Ha, fishes semi diabetic matlab agar aap unko dekhe to unka level wo hamesha diabetic hai, matlab unka normal jaise hamara jo ek level. Fishes are semi diabetic matlab unme jo glucose ka jo maintenance hai blood mein wo bahut poor hai. That is why all the fishes are semi diabetic.
इससे उसका ऑर्गेन पे कोई इफेक्ट नहीं पड़ता होगा बॉडी फिजियोलॉजी पे डायबिटिक होने के बाद?
नहीं, उसको कंपनसेट करने के लिए उसके बहुत सारे तरीके हैं, ठीक है? जैसे कि उसे बहुत ज्यादा फर्क ऐसे नहीं पड़ता क्योंकि दे आर एक्वेटिक एक्चुअली ना, तो वो उस तो ऑस्मो रेगुलेशन, ड्रिंकिंग, यूरिनेशन, बहुत सारी चीजें हैं दैट एक्चुअली कंपनसेट ऑल दोस थिंग्स. ओके
मैम, इसमें एडीएच होता है क्या?
क्या होता है
ADH? एंटी डायबिटिक हार्मोन.
एंटी डायबिटिक हार्मोन्स नहीं होता है तभी तो ये सेमी डायबिटिक है.
ओके
ओके. सो नाउ अनदर सेल्स, दीज आर स्कैटर्ड सेल्स, जक्स्टाग्लोमेरुलर सेल्स और द रेनिन एंजियोटेंसिन सिस्टम. ओके, सो बेसिकली दिस ग्लैंड इट कंटेन्स सम रेनिन ग्रैन्यूल्स. दिस एंड where the renin converted into the renin converts the angiotensin 1 into the angiotensin 2. Okay, and this angiotensin 2 raise the blood pressure and increase the kidney function. Okay, so this is about the today's class about the different endocrine glands. So if any question we can take.
Yes ma'am.
Ma'am a question.
Ma'am. हेलो.
हाँ बोलो
मैम. मतलब ये पूछना था मैम, जैसे ह्यूमंस में हार्मोन का ओवर सिक्रेशन या कम सिक्रेशन के कारण कोई डिजीज या स्ट्रेस कंडीशन होता है, तो फेस में भी ऐसा होता है क्या?
हाँ होता है, बिल्कुल होता है.
तो अभी जो आप स्लाइड में देखे तो उसमें तो कुछ तो नहीं था मैम ऐसा?
क्या मतलब मैंने उससे रिलेटेड डिजीज नहीं डिस्कस की?
यस मैम.
ये कहना चाह रहे ना इसके ओवर सिक्रेशन?
हाँ, तो मतलब जैसे ह्यूमंस में पढ़ते हैं तो उसी समय बताते हैं कि ओवर सिक्रेशन या कम सिक्रेशन से ये हो रहा है.
सिक्स में जो एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम जो है, ठीक है, एंडोक्राइन सिस्टम उतना डेवलप नहीं है जितना ह्यूमंस में है. और उसके साथ साथ जो उसका जो सिस्टम है, ठीक है, जो स्टडीज हैं, जो रिपोर्ट्स हैं, वो उतनी ज्यादा नहीं है जितनी कि ह्यूमंस में है, ठीक है? ऐसे तो और जैसे कि जीएनआरएच की मैं बात कर, एक एग्जांपल ले रहे हैं, जैसे आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट वन हार्मोन जीएनआरएच, रिलीज होता है, हाइपोथैलेमस से रिलीज होता है एंड इट इन्फ्लुएंस द सेक्रेशन ऑफ द जीटीएच1 और जीटीएच2 और वी कैन सी दैट द एलएचएस एलएच और एफएसएच. लेकिन अगर मैं उसी हार्मोन की बात स्पेशलिस्ट में करूं तो जीएनआरएच का जो फंक्शन है वो सिर्फ और सिर्फ जीटीएच1 और जीटीएच2 के सेक्रेशन पे नहीं है, इट हैज सेवरल अदर फैक्टर्स. ओके, सो अगर आप ये बोलना चाहें कि ये पर्टिकुलर डिजीज किसी एक हार्मोन की डेफिशिएंसी या ओवर सेक्रेशन से है तो वो फिशेज में डिफाइन करना बहुत डिफिकल्ट है, क्योंकि फिशेज के जो हार्मोन्स की जो फंक्शन की जो लिमिट्स है या जो बाउंड्रीज है वो बहुत ओवरलैपिंग है. That's why we cannot say that if ये हार्मोन कम होगा तो ये बीमारी हो जाएगी. That is why अगर आप सर्च भी करेंगे, if you go and search for the disease which is caused by the hormonal imbalance in the fishes, you will get very few.
Okay. Thank you.